I am a king, you are a king. Let's all be kings together.
Your Majesty.
My reputation has been ruined and my servant has been shot, sir. Everyone will ask why she did this.
But nobody knows who shot at you. Lady Pole may be put in an asylum.
You and Norrell's men. I'm sold once more. Stephen!
We are no friends to Mr. Norrell.
What happened behind the mirror?
The King's Rose.
Promise me you will not go out in those roads again.
No.
Down magic to hell. Down where it's led us.
Can a magician kill a man by magic?
I suppose a magician might, but a gentleman never could.
He has murdered my book. We must not let this stand. You must not.
I am home. We'll go back to Shropshire, and I will cease to do practical magic. I will write down my thoughts in a book.
Once again, it is the stupid magician who thwarts us. We must find and awaken a Mossosk. He will bargain our life away, and he will have no notion that he has done so.
Napoleon is back.
What?
The Duke. He asks you to renew your commission. I am sorry, Mr. Strange, but your husband is the army's magician, and we have need of him.
Oh!
Jonathan. Have you written much today?
Oh, quite a bit.
Certain you would be.
Well, gentlemen, the war is over. What do you think they'll do with us now?
Come. I want to show you something. The King's Road. You're almost finished.
Bill, you are clever.
That's four of them done, but of course Mr. Murray won't want them engraved.
This is just how it looked. You make me very proud.
The light's very good in here.
But why publish Strange's book, Mr. Murray?
I am a book publisher, Mr. Norrell. Surely it should be no great surprise that I publish a book. Magic is a very popular subject. The Friends of English Magic sells well. Mr. Lascelles' book sold very well, until Mr. Strange reviewed it.
Why undo all this good work by putting out a book so at odds with the orthodoxy?
That would be with your orthodoxy, Mr. Norrell. And how do we know that...
Because that is what he does, sir. Three volumes laying English magic naked for all who choose to salivate over.
I do not know what the end of it will be.
Well, the beginning of it will be that volume one of Mr. Strange's book is published in August.
It is the most dangerous and seditious thing of which I have ever heard.
Publish, and you shall have no more editions of the Friends of English Magic, sir.
That is Mr. Norrell's prerogative.
You have made an enemy of us, sir.
I will. There you go.
The history and practice of English magic. Marvel at what he has done. Dare to dream of what he may yet do. Mr. Strange's remarkable book of magic.
Why on earth does he insist on punishing me in this manner? Whatever wrong did I do him?
None, sir.
It is not for myself I fear, Mr. Lascelles. It is for England. There is a danger both in what he will say and in the very fabrics of the books themselves. Really, it would be most agreeable to me to never see or hear from that man again.
Could there have been, Mr. Hyde?
Well, that was just the beginning. I looked to the south, and I saw a lady walking away from me, just walking on into the snow. Black gown, no shawl, not even a pair of shoes. When I reached the top, she was nowhere.
Forgive me, I do not see why you come to me. You should write to the magistrate.
It was Mrs. Strange, sir.
My mother? My mother is dead. You believe you saw her ghost?
Your wife, sir.
It could not have been my wife.
Mrs. Strange's father was cured in my parish 47 years. I've known her since she took her first steps in Clunbury Church, huh?
Arabella has not left Ashfair this past 5 days. Besides, she never wears black. I hate to see her in black.
I'm not the first to have seen a woman in black wandering hereabouts.
Well, whoever the poor woman is, she is not my wife. We may call Mrs. Strange here. You may see with your own eyes.
No. I do not wish to distress her. Sir, could it not be something to do with your magic?
I have ceased to do practical magic. I did my last at Waterloo. I just write my book now. And Mrs. Strange spends most of her time encouraging me to finish it.
I'm glad Mrs. Strange is sleeping. Sorry for disturbing you, sir. Thank you. Look after her, sir.
Do you think there'll be another war?
It is my most fervent hope that there will not be.
And how do you think things between you and Norrell will fall out?
Like any other dull academic controversy. Books, articles, factions. One of us will win. Posterity will take a little from us both. And then we shall both be forgotten. As for my own future, I wish to spend it quietly with my wife. I should also like to cut down the copper beeches that my father planted and do something about the East Garden.
And what about a child?
That would be a fine thing, would it not?
Then we should see what we can do about it.
Wait a moment.
On a May morning in 1310, the wife of a Christian lighthouse keeper found a cupboard in her kitchen. Do you understand?
No, I'm so sorry.
The cupboard kept calling to her again and again. She told her husband, who thought she was mad. But when she stepped inside the cupboard, she was never seen again. I mean to say she was stolen away.
Your friend, madam. She's in great distress. May I take you to her?
You must send word to Jonathan Strange at Ashfair House. Tell him he must not make the bargain. He must not.
I'm sorry, madam. I do not understand.
I mean to say Moss Oak. Moss Oak. Moss Oak. Mean to say Moss Oak. Moss Oak.
Mary, where is Mrs. Strange?
Is she not still in bed, sir?
No.
Would you find her for me, please?
An hour ago, I saw Mrs. Strange upon the Welsh hills. I have in no doubt, sir, it was her.
Belle? Arabella?
She is not in the house, sir. We do not know where she is.
She'll freeze herself to death.
Bring me some water, Mary. Now! Fill it up.
Mr. Strange,
quiet.
Would we not ride out?
Quiet.
Clumbury, Ash Fair, and the marches.
I think I woke last night.
You did not say this before.
I did not remember before. Arabella was getting out of the bed. My wife.
Do you accept me as your wife?
Yes, yes.
Madam, we must make haste. Please.
You renounce all other wives.
And of course I do, of course. With all my heart.
Where is my friend?
I'm sorry, madam.
Madam! Welcome to Lost Hope.
Oh, she's dreadful cold, sir.
Well, my love, what were you thinking?
Your poor husband.
Your husband has bargained you away, madam. He has sold you to me in exchange for a piece of wood. You are to be mine for all time and never leave.
I tried to tell you of this. Emma. Belle, Emma, take us home, Stephen.
Shh.
I do not offer anything that will not be exquisitely agreeable to you.
My husband will hear of this.
There is no husband. Not anymore.
She is quite peaceful now. What is this you do?
My mother used to tell me tales of magicians, different creatures. It was really what first drew me to magic, the romance of it, the tales I heard when I was a boy. When she died, I went around collecting folk tales, writing them up. And that story Lady Paul told last night, the lighthouse keeper in his cupboard, it made me think I've heard it before. It is much like a tale told by the fishwives of Flamborough about a man called Bloodworth, who lit the lamp in the lighthouse during the 1500s.
Is it a common story?
No. And the way she told it is not quite the same as I have it in my book, but...
And what do you mean to say?
I do not believe Lady Paul's stories are nonsense. I believe there is a pattern to them.
And what do you consider so dangerous about this book?
Everything! Do you think I take the books of English magic to myself because I'm some sort of miser, sir? Because I rub my hands in glee, desiring to have it all? No, sir, no. No, I gather these books because they're so very powerful and dangerous, and Mr. Strange's book is the most dangerous of all.
You consider that his book will give ammunition to the Yuanites?
It is not a matter of consideration, my lord. It is a matter of... I beg your pardon, give ammunition.
The Yuanites? Machine breakers? The rioters in the north.
I do not understand what a rioters have to do with magic.
Do you never look in a newspaper, sir?
No.
These men have lost their employment to the new machines. They destroy factories and looms and proclaim themselves to be the followers of the Raven King. They carry his banner. They daub his blazon on the walls.
There is a ragged preacher going around the north telling people that the Raven King is coming back.
He's not coming back, is he?
Now, this is a ridiculous notion. But I see your anxiety. I see your anxiety. After all, the Raven King has always been associated with riot and revolution.
You think Strange's book will support the Raven King?
Everything he has done and said would say so.
Then we must hope he sees sense. Or that something occurs to stop him.
Yes. Yes, indeed.
not now. I hope you'll forgive the mess I rather thought it was. Now, Henry, do not take on. It is all right. Come now. Let's have something to eat. I can spare half an hour.
May I conduct the funeral?
A funeral, Henry? What would be the point of that?
Well, how else?
There is to be no funeral, Henry. I'm going to bring her back to life.
Okay.
Let's get on.
Jonathan, what do you mean?
Precisely what I say.
But such a thing is not possible. You cannot just...
Perfectly possible, Henry. Believe me. I did such a thing of a rough sort in Spain.
Of a rough sort? Damn it, Jonathan, she's my flesh and blood.
And she is my heart and soul. But it's magic to me otherwise.
How'd it go?
It is the problem of the Yoanite which concerns me. Of course, you are aware of the Yoanite.
I
fear, and I said it to them, that Mr. Strange's book will put fire into their hearts. Mr. Lascelles is of the opinion that I should have an attorney serve Mr. Strange.
Forgive me, sir. I think you take the advice of Mr. Lascelles a little too freely.
Do you indeed? Well, I may say that it was you who suggested that I turn to him and draw light in the first place.
Yes, sir, I know.
If I do not have Mr. Lascelles, I will be quite alone. And Mr. Strange will be free to dictate the direction that English magic will take and spoil everything I have done. I will not have this book, Childermas. Mr. Lascelles will help me to ensure that.
I do not think Mr. Strange will be publishing anything anytime soon, sir. His wife is dead.
Dead?
She went walking in the snow and got to chill.
Mr. Strange will feel that very badly.
And so I beg of you, dear sir, for the sake of any friendship that once we enjoyed, you tell me what magic you employ to bring her ladyship back to the bloom of life. Tell me but this one thing, whatever magic it is, and I promise you I shall tell no one, and that furthermore I shall put aside magic entirely, cease to call myself magician and trouble you no more, your affectionate friend, Jonathan Strange.
What shall I do?
Nothing, sir. There's no need. There is already talk in Shropshire that he killed his wife by black magic, that he has another wife somewhere. If it were now known he plans to raise the original from the dead as he did those Italians, his reputation would be ruined. No one would buy his book.
I rather think Mr. Norrell was asking what he should do to help. Will you not?
Can we talk without the servants present, sir?
No, let's not talk without the servants present. Strange has made his promise. He's a man of his word. You and he can bring Mrs. Strange back between you, I'm sure. I presume you now understand what went amiss with Lady Pole. She need not come back, Matt.
Could we talk without the servants present, sir?
It is most vexing. I mean to say, his first reaction when his wife dies is to turn to black magic.
It is a measure of the man, sir.
But perhaps Childermas is... Well, perhaps if I just explained...
Childermas has his own reasons for doing anything. Mr. Strange has broken with you, sir. He's gone against your wishes time and again, sir.
All you have done is for the good of English magic. You are the good of English magic. Do not allow your goodness to be used against you.
Yes, but...
Write to him, if you wish, but I could not, in all conscience, stand by and see you inflict such damage upon your own cause. I fear I could no longer be your friend.
There's no need to whisper, dear Stephen. He can neither see nor hear us. He is attempting to summon me, ignorant fool.
He may be ignorant, but he still succeeded, sir.
What?
After all, you are here, sir.
Yes, I dare say. But if I choose not to make myself heard nor seen, what use is that? Stephen, quick. Turn the pages of that book. There is no breeze in the room, and it will perplex him. Really? Watching this fellow try to do magic is like seeing a man sit down to eat dinner with his coat on backwards.
He has just lost his wife, sir.
Yes. And what a delicious irony that he summons me. Oh, give his neck a pinch, Stephen. He will think it is a gnat.
It is said the Raven King brought the son of a nobleman with whom he quarreled back to life. Henry Barbatus died of a fever. The king had his body dug up out of its grave. Perhaps it involves some exchange of the life of trees or dogs. Jonathan, the Raven King was nothing if not practical. Wake up.
I'm sorry, my love.
Hey.
7 days, Jonathan.
One more day, I beg you.
No, Jonathan. I believe in the resurrection to eternal life.
Norrell does not want to tell me. I will go to him. I will make him.
Jonathan, stop!
Get out of my way.
You honestly believe this is what Arabella would wish? Do you think she would be pleased with you?
She would be alive, Henry. I wish her to be alive.
But she's dead. The corpse lying upstairs is no longer your wife or my sister. What would it be if you brought it back now? Please stop. Please respect her and respect yourself. It breaks my heart to say this, Jonathan. She's the only family I will ever have. She's my most beloved sister. She must be let go.
You were the very reason I did magic. You were the reason I did anything. The excitement of it was very much to see how you would look at me. The excitement of life was very much to see how you would look at me. Goodbye, Mother.
Shall see God in my flesh. Yea, and I myself shall behold him, not with other, but with these same eyes. For as much as it has pleased Almighty God to take unto himself the soul of our dear sister here departed, we therefore commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, in the sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life, through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Seems a waste for you to have come all this way, Stephen.
Sir Walter wished you to be told in person. He wishes me to stay by you. He considered you might be very distressed by the death of Mrs. Strange.
I am very distressed by what has happened. No one is more distressed than I. I had considered at least it would have given me someone to talk to. But she is so very, very far away.
So it is when someone is dead.
Mr. Black, my colleague and I consider we would fail in our duty of care if we did not ask you something.
What is it, gentlemen?
We know how impatient you and her ladyship are of magicians, sir, but...
The nonsense that she speaks so well, we have been listening to it when it comes. I've been reading my old notes, and I believe it has a pattern, sir.
We were wondering if you think we might induce her to speak in that way in order to study and...
No, I think you may not.
But you see, sir, she speaks in fairy tales, as we would call
Gentlemen,
it.
Gentlemen, do not meddle in such things. You have no idea where it will end, and you are not fit to do it.
But surely if we can help...
No, you cannot. No one can help.
We must accept that she cannot be cured.
And yourself?
You do not have my permission. And I do not want any more talk of it.
Did you see it?
No.
Well, I see it plainly on both of them. I vote we go ahead.
not changed.
Would you tell I was not quite myself for a time? Would you give this to Lady Pole? I think Belle would be pleased to know that your wife had something to remember her by.
I'm sure she would be most comforted. You have not given up magic, then? It is just, I had heard.
What did you heard? I am no longer a practical magician. That does not mean I have abandoned magic.
Norrell is in agonies whenever your book is mentioned.
Agonies? Well, the book is only the beginning. I mean to say, when you consider the matter, what does our so-called restoration of English magic really amount to? What have Norrell and I actually done? Illusions, storms and bad weather, his silly sea beacons.
He still has not completed them.
Compare our sorry reckoning with the magicians of the Golden Age. They transformed themselves into mice, foxes, rivers. They made ships out of cobwebs and houses out of rose bushes.
Mr. Strange, I do not much like saying it, but it occurs to me Norrell may be right. These kinds of magic will not suit us nowadays.
How can you say that when none of us knows what magic it is? No, we must turn our attention to the life and magic of the Raven King. And when we do...
I'm sorry, Mr. Strange. That is the one thing we must not do. I'm serious. I tell you this as a friend. Too much talk of other kings is bound to make the government nervous.
How can we restore English magic until we know what it is we're supposed to be restoring?
We do not require English magic to be restored any more than it already has been. Leave John Uskglass in the obscurity Mr. Norrell has placed him.
Norrell has poisoned your minds, literally in your case. Do you not consider what happened to your wife? Do you not question why she went mad?
Madness is what it is not.
Whatever you hope to gain from this...
My liberty, Stephen. Mine and hers.
You cannot fight him. Mrs. Strange. She doesn't know what is done. She is happy. You and I. We have survived so far.
What would you suggest, Stephen?
We should accept our position and be thankful for it.
He has poisoned your mind. So, gentlemen, what are we to do?
Try and describe what most distresses you, my lady.
There was once a Christian who went hunting in a wood of witch elm. His horse got its hoof caught in a rabbit hole and he tumbled in. He found himself in a strange country, lit by its own sun and nurtured by its own rain. In a wood very much like the one he had just left, he found a brew where a party of gentlemen, some of them rather odd, were playing natural.
Here, the huntsman and the rabbit hole. But you heard us say brew.
And, natural, what is that?
I think it is a card game, rather like what we would call Spoil Five. I think it best if you speak generally, my lady. If you aim right for the truth, you veer off at even stranger angles.
Yes.
Speak around it this time.
There was once a farmer of Harrogate who desired very greatly to grow broad beans bigger than any in Yorkshire. To this end, he enlisted the assistance of Cole Tom Blue, who helped him grow beans as large as a man's foot.
Madam, please, we must stop this.
Go on.
Cole Tom Blue had enchanted the beans as a means to capture the souls of the little children. The little children were then carried off to the castles of the Five.
I have it. Castles of the Five. That's a common story about a fairy, but he's unnamed. You called him Cole Tom Blue. I think we what you are telling, my lady, are fairy tales, but told in some way from the point of view of the fairy himself.
Human tales, as it were.
Is this my house?
Yes, it most certainly is.
I've my mum for you. It's blue.
Blue?
With your permission, madam, we would like to write to Mr. Strange.
Yes, please.
Mrs. Salami,
Mrs. Armstrong. Excuse us, mama.
Market's pinching, shouting all sorts of nonsense about Raven King. And it all you to bring him.
What is the matter?
Madman.
I've met you before. And you, I have a message for you. Nameless slave. Unhand me. The rain shall make a door for me
and
I shall
go
through it.
Do you see anything in this that might be called seditious?
I see that it will tear England to pieces. I see that it will spoil magic for generations to come. Why did you not let me have my magical court?
From what I understand from my man at Murray's, there is no direct call for the restoration of the Raven King, but such a call would not be against the law as it currently stands. May we keep this for a while?
We will remain in touch.
I do not know how I shall prevent him. I do not know.
What do you want to prevent him for? Call a halt to this bloody, stupid feud. It won't end well for you both.
Join him if you wish. Join him and Maury and the other traitors.
I'm not going anywhere, don't worry.
That is a shame. I agree with you, though. Between us, I'm sure we can put a halt to Strange's book.
Childermas? Is that you? I've been expecting you. I was your master.
Poorly, sir. Colds and headaches and tremblings in the limbs, all the usual symptoms when someone has vexed him. And no one vexes him as you do.
And what does he think about you turning yourself into shadows, making yourself invisible?
I've been 18 years in Mr. Norrell's service. And before that, I was a pickpocket. I would have to be a dull fellow to have learned nothing at all.
That was not what I asked. Well, come and see what you were sent to see. I have nothing to hide.
They are very beautiful.
I aim for the whole book to be a work of beauty.
So these are the king's rods?
Built by the Raven King himself.
What is the country that the bridges cross?
I do not know. What is your opinion, magician?
I suppose it is fairy. Was the magic difficult?
You need a spell of revelation. I used Doncaster. And another of dissolution to melt the mirror's surface. Do you follow me?
Yes, sir. Have these landscapes always been there?
I believe so.
Why have magicians not been able to go about upon them?
These roads were all closed, hidden behind mirrors. But now, something has occurred to open them up again. Now there is more magic in England than either you or I can understand.
I think that is true.
Is it not time, Childermas, that you left Gilbert Norrell's service and came to me? Then he'd be none of this servant nonsense. You would be my pupil and assistant.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
And Mr. Null and I not done with each other yet. Besides, I think I would make a very bad pupil. Worse even than you.
Was I so very bad? I merely ask questions. Surely that is the prerogative of any pupil.
I do not know how it will end with you and Norrell. But I'll tell you what I'll do. If you fail and Norrell wins, I shall leave his service. I'll take up your cause, and then there will still be two magicians in England and two opinions upon magic. But if he should fail and you win, I'll do the same against you. Good enough. Thank you for your frankness, sir.
It is Norrell who likes to keep secrets, not I. Besides, I've told you nothing that is not already in my book. Within a month, every man, woman, and child in the kingdom will be able to read it and form his own opinions on it, which is just as it should be.
Regarding that, sir, I think I should warn you to be careful.
Of what?
Of your book, sir.
What do you mean?
It's trying to have it stopped.
How?
By whatever means he can, I think.
God damn him. God damn him. What have I ever done to him, Childermas? What did I ever do, apart from be frank and pleasant? This book will stand as tribute to my wife.
Mr. Strange.
God damn! No!
Bloody idiot.
Mr. Norrell is not at home, sir.
Oh! Mr. Norrell! What is this? You quarrel with my book?
Your book cannot be published, sir. We will not allow it.
Fine. What on earth does it matter? Leave me be. Do you not consider you have hurt me enough?
Do you not consider you have hurt Mr. Norrell enough?
What hurt? I wrote begging with everything I could offer that he helped do for my wife what he did for Lady Polk. I pleaded, sir, on any condition that he helped me bring my wife back. And he did not even reply. What was the magic? Why would you not tell me? I know why. Charlatan! You're no friend of mine!
Heartbreaker! Hold him in!
Most terrible things are being done against you. They seek to arraign you for breaking into Norrell's house.
They say I killed Bell.
They say that if a charge can be found under modern law, they plan to try you for murder by witchcraft. So what do you mean to do?
I shall summon a fairy.
I do not think that germane to your situation.
You are wrong. I wonder if such a thing is even possible. The received opinion is that fairies do not visit England anymore. But I tell you, I was in company with one at Windsor Castle. No magician of any era could help me as much as a fairy. I've tried every spell I know, this way and that. Nothing seems to work. But then I thought on it. I did not see the fairy. That is the difficulty, to see and hear them. Yet there was one present who perceived him very clearly. Why could he, when I could not?
Merlin, let me bring you out of here.
It's very important that I do this, Grant.
Well, was this fellow a magician?
No, this man was just mad.
For now, what must be done is to get you away from here. We will enlist Wellington's help.
Sir, open this door. This is the Duke of Wellington's man.
He will not have you slandered, so.
But then again, madness is not such a very queer notion. Think of the magicians of the Golden Age. They were the fairies' near neighbors in wildness, insanity. Perhaps I am too tame.
Mr. Strange, listen.
But how does one work out a little madness in oneself? Perhaps I should go wandering. Perhaps the wilderness will make me mad. I think you hit upon something, Grant. My book is finished. London is set against me. It is time for me to become the magician I am destined to be.
Madam! You cannot propose that you purposely become a lunatic. You will only help your enemies. What must be done now is to take you away from here.
Come on! Jailer!
Come on, man.
That's a double.
Merlin!